trust.
Welcome back to Newstalk for this half hour. I'm joined by Deb Cabral, the Declutter Coach. If you've got any questions about decluttering your life, your mind, your office, your home, 793-WKTV is the number to call, and Deb will hopefully be able to give you a few pointers. During the break, we were talking about springtime, time for some spring cleaning, open up the windows and airing out the house and just kind of getting yourself organized for the summer. Any good tips to get us started?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm working with a lot of families now that still have the boots and the coats and the hats and gloves and all of that, and so I say let's get that stuff out and bring in the beach towels and the spring coats and your beach bags so that everything is easily accessible so that when you need it, it's there for you. So mud rooms are a big thing to declutter now. Mm-hmm. I'm also working with a lot of families on organizing their pantry, and we've got, I think, behind you the class that I'm teaching at MV. This is a great time. You know, in the winter we were eating a lot of stews and soups, but you really want to switch and eat, you know, lighter and somewhat healthier in the summer, salads and different pasta dishes. And so I do help a lot of families declutter and get their kitchen and pantry in order so that they readier to eat healthy food.
Now, as we move everything from, you know, all that winter stuff that we're packing up and we're putting away, do you ever run into issues with people where, like, the you know, something becomes just a collecting ground, whether it's the basement or the closet, and they just shove everything away? Is there a way to balance that out?
Yeah, I just worked with a client yesterday, and she said, you know, we have to surprise my husband. This is our bonus room, and it's just a dumping ground, and that's what it's been all winter. So what we did is we moved things that could be in another area of the house. Some of the things, like camping things, for example, they do a lot of winter camping and hiking. So we got those all into nice clear plastic bins, labeled them, and put them in their basement, which is a very dry area. And she, you know, the client was a little concerned about using the basement, really didn't store much there. And, you know, once you work with people and, you know, you can evaluate, yes, this is a, you know, a good place to be able to store other things, that bonus room opened up. And what we're going to do for her is make a nice craft area for her and her daughter, as well as a sewing area and a wrapping area. You know, a lot of young kids, you're always going to birthday parties. She had a lot of things that would get ruined because they weren't stored properly. She'd buy gift bags and wrapping paper, and by the time she needed them, they were no longer useful because they had kind of been, you know, just kind of thrown in. So.
And a lot of people may not realize that, like, one of your specialties is you definitely can help people, and you've done in the past and talked about it, in small spaces. When you're working with a small space, things tend to pile up very quickly, but you can kind of, you come in and you kind of help them figure out what's there, what doesn't need to be there. What are the biggest challenges with smaller spaces versus, say, like a loft?
Yes, the biggest challenge with a small space is making sure that you're using all of the space properly. Mm-hmm. And I say vertical space, floor to ceiling. A lot of folks, when I come in, they say, I don't have any closet space, I don't have enough room, but they're not really looking at other ways that we can do to improve the room that you have. And we were talking earlier on the break that I've recently partnered with JK Lumber, great family-owned business, and helping them promote a new line of closet systems called Freedom Rail. And what I love about Freedom Rail, it's very flexible. So even in the smallest of space, we can install a very affordable, flexible system that will give us the ability to add drawer space and even counters and shelves, and be able to fluctuate those so that if your needs change or if you want to even move it from room to room, we've done that in the past too.
So you're not locked in.
You're not locked in, and it's very easy to install and very affordable.
Nice. Now, is it tough as you work with your clients to, because some people get attached to a lot of things.
Yes.
Is it hard to convince people this needs to go, you can keep this, but this is completely ridiculous and unnecessary? Do you run into that a lot?
Yes, I do. And believe it or not, I do a lot with my corporate clients. You would think that that really would only appear, you know, to residential clients having
home,
that problem.
Yeah.
But no. A lot of my corporate clients, too, they have too much clutter in their office or at their workspace. And so one of the things that I try to tell people is that in addition to your home being your sanctuary and it's kind of projection of who you are, your workspace is the same way. I can give one example. I had a client in New Jersey, large company, and was going in to do a declutter day with them. So I did a motivational speech and then kind of went around and spoke to individuals in their office and workspace. And one of the individuals liked to collect turtles, which is a great thing. But what happened is instead of people coming to her cubicle and talking to her and looking at her from a business perspective and really respecting her, you know, business acumen, they were looking at the turtles and calling her the turtle lady. So it's a projection of you and also of your professionalism. So mm-hmm. sometimes having that extra extraneous stuff around is actually taking away from you mm-hmm. and who you are as a person and what your professional abilities are. And so a lot of folks don't really see it as that. And so that clutter really was becoming almost like business clutter and professional clutter in mm-hmm. addition to being physical clutter.
And for people who work in like an office space, you know, do you have any tips in terms of organization? Because sometimes papers like pile up all over the place, you know, a week goes by and you just find yourself buried in it. Any kind of generic or overall tips that people should look to?
Yeah, what I tell people is that you have to have an effective filing system. And filing is not for storage, it's for retrieval. Mm-hmm. So everything that you save should be something that at some point you're going to be able to, you need to retrieve. So what you need to do is have very efficient files that are properly labeled that you're going to be able to find what you need, and then keep that one paper to-do list. So you don't have all of that on your desk. It's very overwhelming to have a lot of clutter on your desk. So my thing is, you know, put it away in places where you can retrieve it when you need it and work off that daily to-do list.
All right, and we should give you a shout out here in my chair is breaking again. This is, we were fearing during the break, the website right there, declutter coach deb.com is your website.
Yes.
And there they'll find the tips such as what you gave today.
Yes.
And a bunch of other stuff.
And some upcoming classes at MV.
All right, Deb Cabral, always
great.
A pleasure.
Yes.
Thank you so
great
much.
Great to see you, Dave.
Don't
Thank
go anywhere.
You.
News to Go is coming up.